when I started, I was definitely in the vein of looking for an adrenaline thrill. And some of the first people that I explored with were graffiti types. These were the people who saw the city the way I saw it, being a fantastic playground. If there's a bridge and there's a walkway on it, anybody can do that. I'm excited about going up to the very top of it. There's so many barriers thrown up to people really experiencing the built environment that I've decided I'm going to be an outlaw. At this point, I'll just go and I'll hop the fence. I'd rather not get caught, but I'm willing to accept that risk. We're right on the edge of English Kills, which is a little channel off Newtown Creek in the Bushwick area of Brooklyn. At its peak, it had more freight tonnage per mile than the Mississippi River. You can see the twin outfalls of what was Brooklyn's largest sewer up until the 1880s. These little old industrial wasteland corners have been literally just fenced off and forgotten about. I really fell in love with the idea that there was this huge unseen world. When rain starts coming down, drains can fill up real quick. We went into Kissena Corridor Drain, along a route that used to be a natural creek that flowed out into the Long Island Sound. So this is where we should go in. I found a reference to the lake being drained. So let me know if you see anybody coming. Just from the context, I knew that it was a pretty significant channel. I just tried to look at old maps, find out what the original course of the stream was, and then I just poked around until I found some manholes that seemed to lead into something big. Okay. It's usually with a sense of excitement that I go in to some place like that, even when it is an incredibly boring concrete tunnel.
If there's nobody out there, come on.
Kind of hard to not do it once I realized how much is out there. I get it. It's not in an easy place. Just if it opens, sometimes people come by and want to know who's down there. Sound of rushing water over there is the infall from the lake. And it is really slippery. It's not normally like this, but it's been raining so much I think that it's all slippery. Prior to the 1939 World's Fair, Robert Moses spearheaded a giant landscaping project, which included enclosing the natural stream bed inside those giant concrete tubes. There's several miles of these giant tunnels big enough to drive a truck through. Going there, I get to see a way in which the city has really shaped its natural environment in an impressive way, but that it's generally hard to see for most people.
We went to MH29, by the way.
This side's a little bit more full.
Back.
Not normally nearly that much. I've run into some dangerous situations. Usually it's just stupidity.
I think there's one more doorway over here.
One of the scariest times I've ever had was in another large drain. These storm drains were tidally affected, which I didn't know when I went in, which happened to be at low tide. When we started coming back out of the drain, the tide was coming in. It was terrifying because there I was in pitch black tunnels in vicious black sucking water. We eventually came out a different manhole. That isn't always as easy as it sounds. You don't want to pop up out of a manhole onto a busy street. In Moscow, we were in this underground river and rain was creating a little bit of flooding. We had to pop out a manhole right near the Kremlin. We're detained by some of the military police. It scared me shitless.
I'm just gonna go through and into the other channel.
I was taking pictures at the site where Kissena Park Lake drains into that tunnel. What I'm trying to do is to delve into the unseen layers. The physical layering is just a way of getting at the historical layering. I'll go into subway tunnels. That'll take me back to the early 20th century. Down another level to a sewer, and that might take me back in time to the early 1800s. Second place, this underground spring welled up through a crack in the concrete floor and was spraying into the air. That underground spring is one of the sources of water that fed into the creek when it was a natural water course. You see an urban landscape, and you feel like it's entirely a man-made project. It's actually a long process that's created that landscape, and it's a dialogue between what people want to have there and the natural world that already was there. So many of these places are just actually triumphs that cities have created. I'm not a bad guy. I'm not doing any damage. I want to be able to continue hopping fences because red tape is just a bitch and a half to get through.